more changes may be in store for a wrestling organization that can't seem to get their collective acts together. Attention and good evening, Hotline fans. Some wrestlers may be leaving, some by choice, and some not by choice, if you get my drift. This organization right now teetering on the verge of collapse. The president of this company has gone on record disputing publicly that there are many problems. But I've uncovered information that has led me to believe the real story is still to be told. Folks, this report is hot, 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 and it's available right now, up until midnight, at 1-900-909-9900. That's 1-900-909-9900. $1.69 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission before calling, but do call right now.
Back on WCW Saturday night, making his way to the ring at this time, youngster, power plant graduate, Evan Karagias, going to be taking on a veteran in Kendall Windham. That's next up.
Well, another example of that open door policy. We'll see Kendall Windham return to World Championship Wrestling against this young man, Evan Karagias, the rookie.
Great abs on Evan Karagias. Boy, what I'd kill for that. Yikes.
Scott, this past Thursday on Thunder from Columbus, Ohio, it was the Macho Man Randy Savage continuing his NWO problems. Hollywood Hogan, Brian Adams, the whole troop. The NWO attacked the Macho Man Randy Savage. And who came to the rescue? None other than the world's heavyweight champion, WCW Sting, made the save for Savage as we head into Uncensored.
We saw on Nitro last Monday night from Philadelphia that Sting and Savage can function as a tag team and do very well as a tag team. I think that Randy Savage's days as a member of the New World Order, as we know it, those days are numbered. I think Savage may be forming a new NWO. He may be trying to branch off, open up this, maybe like a USFL type version of the NWO, hopefully with a lot more success.
Well, remember that Randy Savage questioned Hogan's leadership abilities. He claims that while half of the NWO members will shake Hogan's hand in a face-to-face situation, that bottom line, they would love to stab Hogan right in the back.
Well, it's like I've said before, Mike, and you'll bear me out on this. You look at the roster of the New World Order. Hollywood Hogan, Kurt Hennig, Kevin Nash, Scott Hall, Conan, Brian Adams, Buff Bagwell, Scott Steiner, all the way down. Scott Norton, Rick Rude, the entire group. They all turned their back on somebody. They stabbed somebody in the back to gain entrance into that organization. I don't see how they can trust anybody in that group. That's why I wouldn't join it on a bet.
Also, as we head into Uncensored, despite doctor's orders that he should not enter the ring, covered by Karagias and gets a two count, the Giant will return to action at Uncensored to face Kevin Nash. And we understand that later in this program, we will have the footage from this past Monday on Nitro. If you haven't seen it, with, of all things, the Giant.
Yeah.
Jackknife powerbombing Kevin Nash. If you haven't seen it, you don't want to miss it. And if you even witnessed it this past Monday on Nitro, it's certainly worth a second look.
No question about it. Although the Giant having to part with a good bit of money there, maybe having to get somebody to post his bail, it was worth it. He got to jackknife powerbomb Kevin Nash, and I'd like to put that on a continuous loop and just watch it over and over and over again. Kevin Nash deserved it, and my money is on the Giant doing it again at least once a week from tomorrow night at Uncensored.
What a deep lineup that is at Uncensored. Top to bottom, incredible star power from the main event to the opening match.
You talk about the A-list, the A-team. It's all going to go down a week from tomorrow night on pay-per-view. Sting and Hall, Hogan Savage, Giant Nash, Bret Hart, Kurt Hennig, the list goes on. This is the Major League week from tomorrow night at Uncensored.
Big power move, the slam out on the concrete floor by Kendall Windham. And you know, Windham's physical development in the past couple of years has really opened the eyes of the WCW Executive Committee. It was almost as if Kendall Windham was in the shadow of his older brother and his father, Blackjack Mulligan.
Well, Kendall Windham, another second-generation competitor. That's a first-generation knife-edge chop, though, on Evan Karagias. Good night. And a big left hand from Kendall. You know, it is a Saturday night taping night today here in Johnstown, PA. That means the executive committee back behind closed doors. Who knows what could happen there? It could be nothing. It could be huge. We never know what's going to come out. I went back to try to grab a sandwich during the commercial break. No go. Can't even get in there. They may be up to something. Stay with us. We may have an announcement from those guys later. Kendall misses the splash in the corner, and Evan Courageous fires back with a couple of right hands.
Well, the window of opportunity opens for Evan Courageous. He follows up, catches the big man, Kendall Windham, with a drop kick.
Shoots Kendall in and catches him with the elbow. Wow. Courageous, springboard, moonsault, cross body, caught him, cover, and he got the two count on Kendall. Give Kendall credit. You don't just kick out of that.
And a nicely executed move off the top by Courageous. But there the inexperience of the youngster shows as he walked right into the corner. And Windham now measures him with those open hand knife-edge chops.
And Kendall Windham, bulldog out of the corner. That may do it. The cover, the two, and the three. And it's a victory for Kendall.